Hello friends, welcome to the YouTube channel of AptiMania. I'm Abhishek Gangayat and in this video we are going to discuss type 2 problems of topic time and work. So I have categorized type 2 as the problem in which the work is done on alternate basis. Like on some days A is working alone and on some other days B is coming to help him out. So here's the first example. A can do a piece of work in 100 days. So if A works alone, so he can complete the piece of work in 100 days. B can do the same piece of work in 400 days, right? They started working on it on alternate basis, starting with A. So that means on first day, A is coming to do the work. On second day, B will come. Then on third day, A will come. Then on fourth day, B will come and so on. So this cycle will continue, right? So in how many days will the work be completed? So we'll stick to our original method only, that is the LCM method. So the LCM of these two numbers, we will assume the total work as the LCM of these two numbers, so which is 100 and 400. The LCM of these two numbers is 400. So the total amount of work was 400 units. A was completing this 400 units in 100 days. So A was doing basically 4 units of work per day. And similarly, B was doing 400 by 400, that is 1 unit of work per day. Now on first day, A must have completed 4 units. On second day, B must have completed 1 unit. On third day, A must have completed 4, then B 1, then A 4, then B 1 and so on. So can we say that this is a cycle of 2 days where A and B in a span of 2 days are completing 5 units of work, right? On the next 2 days, they are again completing 5 units. In next 2 days, they are again completing 5 units and so on. Right, so we can say that in 2 days they are completing 5 units, but they need to complete 400 units. So to get 400 from this 5, we need to multiply here by 80. So here also we should multiply it by 80. So our answer comes out to be 160 days. So they will complete the work in 160 days working in this pattern. Right, so next example. Mr. X can write a book in 50 days. X can write a book in 50 days. And his son Mr. Y can alone write the book in 200 days. Now he helps him in his work on every alternate day. So that means on first day X alone was working. On second day X and Y both were working. On third day X alone. Fourth day X plus Y both. Fifth day X alone. On sixth day X plus Y both and so on. Right. So here also we can say that here the cycle is of 2 days since the same cycle is repeating again and again, right? So again, that let us assume that total work to be LCM of 50 and 200, that is 200 only. So the total work was 200 unit. X was doing 50, X was taking 50 days to complete the total work. So he was doing 200 units by 50 days, that is 4 units of work per day. Now Y was doing 200, he was requiring 200 days to complete the work. So he was doing 200 by 200, that is 1 unit of work per day. So on the first day, 4 units were completed. On the second day, 5 units were completed. Again, on the third day, 4 units were completed. On the fourth day, 5 units were completed and so on. So we can say that this is a cycle of 2 days. And this cycle of 2 days, they are completing a total of 9 units of work, right? Now to complete 100 units of work, see 100 is not a multiple of 9. 100 is not a, sorry, 200 is not a multiple of 9. So what we will do is, we will multiply this by a number which is close to 200 and less than 200, right? So we need to get here 198 and we know that 9 into 22 will give us 198. So here also we will multiply it by 22. So in 44 days, they must have completed 198 units of work. But the total work was 200 units. So still 2 units of work is remaining. Now on 45th day, it is odd number of day. And on every odd number of day, only X is coming to work. So X will come to work and he can complete a total of 4 units per day. But the work is only, the leftover work is only 2 units. So he will require 2 by 4 day. That is, he will require half day to finish the work. So the total number of works required by them to complete the work is 44 1 by 2, that is 44.5 days. Right? So, moving to next question. Sunny Deol can do a piece of work in 10 days. His brother Abhay can do the work in 20 days. And his father Dharmendra can do the same work in 50 days. Right? Now, Dharmendra started the work. So, he was coming to the work on first day and was accompanied by Abhay and Sunny on every even number of days. So, on first day, which was odd, only Dharmendra was here to work. On the second day, which was even, all three were working together. On the third day again, which is odd, Dharmendra and Arun was doing the work. On the fourth day, which is even, all three were working together. Similarly, on the fifth day, Dharmendra and Arun alone was working. On the sixth day, all three were working together. Right? A, B and S. So, let us assume the total work to be LCM of 10, 20 and 50. So, LCM of 10, 20 and 50 is 100 units. So, let us assume that the total work was 100 units. Now, A was doing S. S was doing these 100 units in 10 days. So, per day work of Sunny, that is S, was 10 units per day. Abhay was completing 100 units in 20 days. So, per day work of Abhay was 100 by 20, that is 5 units per day. Similarly, Dharmendra was doing 100 units in 50 days. So, his per day work was 2 units. Right. Now, on the first day, they are completing 2 units of work. On the second day, they are completing 2 plus 5 plus 10. That is 17 units of work. Then again, on the third day, they are completing 2 units of work. Then on the fourth day, again 17. Then 2, then 17 and so on. So, again, here is a cycle of 2 days. So, in a cycle of 2 days, the work which is getting completed is 19 units. 2 on the first day and 17 on the second day. Right? So, the total work was here 100 units. And the closest multiple of 19, which is closest to 100, is 95. So, here we need to multiply by 5. So, here also we will multiply it by 5. So, in 10 days, they will complete 95 units of work. Now, 11th day, which is odd number of day, only Dharmendra will come to work. As only Dharmendra is coming to work on odd number of days. So, on 11th day, Dharmendra will come and complete 2 units of work. So, total 97 units of work is completed till now, till 11th day. Now, on the 12th day, they all will come, right? Now, the remaining work is only 3 units, but they complete 17 units per day. So, they will take 3 by 17 day to complete the remaining work, right? So, the total number of days required to complete the work is 11, 3 by 17 or 11 complete days and 3 by 17 remaining days. Now, in the question, it is asked that find the integral number of days. So, see, they cannot complete the work, complete work in 11 days. So, the minimum integral number of days in which they can complete the work is 12. The next integer value to this. Right? So, all three working in this pattern can complete the work in 12 days. Next example. A, B and C can complete a piece of work in 40, 60 and 120 days respectively. A can complete it in 40 days. B in 60 days and C in 120 days respectively. Now, they work like A works on 1st, 4th and 7th dates of a particular month, B on 2nd, 5th and 8th and C on 3rd, 6th and 9th. So, suppose this is the month 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 and so on. So, A will work on this day 1st, then 4th, then 7, then 10 and so on. So, basically A works for one day, then takes a leave of 2 days, then again will return to work, then will take a leave of 2 days and so on. Now, B will come on 2nd, on 5th, on 8th, on 11th and so on. And C will come on 3rd, 6th, 9th, 12th and so on. Right? Now, this is the pattern that they are following to complete the work. Now, let us assume the total work to be LCM of 40, 60 and 120. That is the number 120 itself. So, The total work was 120 units, suppose. So A was doing 120 units in 40 days. So per day work of A was 3 units. Per day work of B was 120 by 60, that is 2 units. And per day work of C was 120 by 120, that is 1 unit. Now on first day, the work completed by A was 3 units. On second day, B completes 2 units of work. On third day, C completes 1. Then again, A will complete 3 units, B will complete 2, and C will complete 1, and so on. So this cycle continues and this till the work is completed, and this cycle is of 3 days. Now this is repeating after every 3 days, right? So we can write it as, in 3 days they are completing a total of 3 plus 2 plus 1, that is 6 units. So in 3 days they are completing 6 units. Right? So to complete a total of 120 units, we need to multiply this 6 by 20. So here also we will multiply this by 20. So they required a total of 60 days to complete the work. Right? So since the same cycle is repeating, so we can directly do it like this. So they are completing 6 units in 3 days. So they need to complete a total of 120 units. So 6 units per day. So in 3 days. So to get 120, we need to multiply here by 20. We'll do the same here also. So 3 into 20 is 60 days. So in 60 days, they will complete the work working in this particular pattern. Next example. A can complete a piece of work in 100 days. B and C can do the same piece of work in 150 days and 60 days respectively. So first of all, let us assume the total amount of work, total quantity of work, that is LCM of 100 and 150 and 60. Which is 300. So the total work was 300 units. So A was doing 300 by 100, that is 3 units per day. B was completing 300 by 150, that is 2 units per day. And C was completing 300 by 60, that is 5 units work per day. Now A was accompanied by B on every second day and was accompanied by C, B and C both on every third day. So basically A is starting the work. So B comes to help in on every second day. And both B and C comes to help in third day. So on first day A will work alone. On second day B will come to help in. And on the third day both B and C will come to help in. Now on the fourth day A will again work alone. On the fifth day B will come to help. And on the sixth day both ABC will work together. On the 7th, A alone. On the 8th day, A and B. And on the 9th day, ABC together. And so on. So see, on the first day, A is alone, working alone, is completing 3 units. On the second day, A and B working together completes 5 units. On the third day, all 3 working together complete a total of 10 units. Right? On the fourth day, again 3. Then again 5. Then again 10. Then again 3, 5, 10. So this is a cycle of 3 days, right? We can easily see that the cycle here is of 3 days. And in 3 days, the total work that is completed is nothing but 18 units, right? And we need to complete 300 units. But 300 is not a multiple of 18. So the closest multiple of 18, which is very closest to 300, is 288. Which we'll get on multiplying 18 by 16. So here also we'll multiply it by 16. So this will give us 48. Right? So in 48 days, total work completed by all three of them working in this particular manner is 288 units. Now on 49th day, A will come alone to work. So A will complete 3 units. So the total work completed till now is 291 units. Now on 50th day, both A and B will come to work, right? So both A and B will come to work and they together do a total of 5 units. So they will do a total of 5 units of work. So the total work completed is 296 units. Now only 4 units is left. And on the 51st day, all 3 will come together. 51 is a multiple of 3. So they are coming together on every multiple of 3, 3rd day, 6th day, 9th day. So on 51st day, they all will come together. Now they need to do a total of 4 units, but working together they can complete a total of 10 units, right? So the time required by them to complete 4 units of work is 10 by 4, right? Because they can do a total of 10 units per day and they need to do only 4 units. So the time required is 4 by 10th of a day. So in total, the number of days required by them to complete the work is, this we can simplify it in 2 by 5. The total number of days required is 50 complete days and 2 by 5 additionally. So a total of 52 by 5 days are required to complete the work by ABC working in this particular manner. So I hope this second type of questions are also clear to you. In case you are feeling any doubt or you have any queries related to CLAT, Bank, or CAT, you can post your queries on our respective Facebook pages. Thank you so much for watching the video. I will continue with the third type in the next video.